How are you all? We are your friend Rajnikant, Excel Guru. Sorry for delay, guys. Actually, I was very much busy in my schedule. For that reason, I'm unable to upload any certain videos about Excel. Now, here it is. I'll try to complete 10 questions in one video if it is possible. If it is not possible, I will make it a part 2. Now, okay, everyone know that frequency will count only the numbers, but here I will show how to do this values that is not a number, not at all numbers. See, okay, here I will explain you. First of all, what you will do, first of all, everyone know match will take lookup value, only the one value, but I will give more than one value. Okay, so select this. So it considers an array. A lookup value will be the same thing, comma 0. It will show us the position where we occur, where it is. Okay, like guys, see, if it is duplicate, it will pick up only this thing. If it is duplicate, it will pick up only this thing, like this. Okay, match will look up only the first occurrence. Okay, if it is more than one duplicate, then also it will pick up only the first occurrence of the value. Because here is having some special characters, so I want to add tilde. It is called tilde. Okay, you will find above the tab key. Here we added some characters, so here also we have to add the product. Sometimes it will show you like this. Okay, you have to use control shift and enter. Okay, now 95% it will handle arrow. If error, if you find any error in this function. So you will just blank control 600. Okay guys, if you change, I'll change, okay, the new thing. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 3. Automatically update. Okay, totally 7. Now coming to this part with VLOOKUP. I will show you how to do with VLOOKUP. Okay. Very good. I will delete this one. First of all, we need the position. Okay. By VLOOKUP, I will do how to do. First of all, we need the position. Okay. Match. Control backspace. Control shift right arrow. Sorry. Equal to match. We need the lookup value. This one. Comma. And lookup array. Control shift left arrow. F4, comma 0. So it will show us the position. Right? I'll drag this formula. Control R. It's a relative reference. See. So relative reference, it will take this one. So May is in 6th position, October is 11th position. Now with VLOOKUP, I will show you how to do. VLOOKUP, look up this, comma, retrievable array, control shift, right arrow, down arrow. F4, we need from 6 to 11, right? Curly bracket, 6, comma, 7, 8, comma, 9, comma, 10, comma, 11. Okay, comma, 0, exact match. Everyone know lookup will take second column, third column number, fourth column number. But here it's the array constraint. This is called array constraint. F9, it will pick up all the things. Okay. Simply wrap this into some product. Control enter. See, okay. It's not yet over, guys. See what I will do is equal to 6 ampersand. I'll show you the magic, guys. And still at that F9. So it will pick up like this only. We want 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, right? So just grab this into row, open the bracket, indirect this thing. Close parenthesis, F9. Got the magic. Now just copy this one, Control C. Come to here, F2. In case of column index, just paste over that one. Control Enter. To do implicit intersection, you have to use Control Shift and Enter. If you change this one to dynamically this change. Okay. If you have any doubt, please let me know in the comment box. Now coming to second number. Okay. What I said, find the last day of the weekday. Here is the date. You have to find the last day of the weekday. Okay, for this month. For this month you have to find the last day of the weekday. Okay. It is 2nd May. Okay, it is 2nd May. Okay. So what I'll do, EVO month of this, comma, minus 1 means it's the previous month, 0 means present month or current month, 1 means next month, F9. So it will give you the serial number, find the last day of the weekday. Just simply write this into. Last day of the weekday. Last day will be the comma. That's it. Wednesday. If you change this any number, 01, 05, 06, 20, 20. Okay, now find the last Friday date. You have to find the last Friday date. This one will be the last Friday date for this month. function. Zero one. Same function I will show you. Number of months. Minus one. It will show you last month, last year. In this first. First 9. So it will show you first June. Okay, if you want, you can press it. First June. Okay. Now, we need end of this month. Okay. Simply. Same this thing, comma zero. Last nine. All dates will come. All dates will come. From here to 30th June of 2020. Okay. Now, what you need is text of this, comma DDD. Four dates. Equal to private. Just simply I'm locking, I'm not dragging this formula to anywhere, simply locking. Okay. That's nice. Wherever it finds this Friday, it will show us the truth. Okay, we are interested in last what you say last Friday, right? I'm copying this text thing because I have to use control C. Look up. Approximate and last lookup value. Lookup 2, 1 divided by. Okay. Simply I will show you. It will show, it won't give you any answer. Now lookup vector will be. Lookup vector will be the date. Now check. F9. Control enter. If you change this Friday to Monday, sometimes June, it is changing or not, Sunday, this Sunday, 28th. Dynamically, it is changing, right guys? 3 is over, now 4. Exact count and those numbers, it is repeating maximum times. Okay, it is repeating maximum times. Okay, first of all, we have to count mod dot multi this one number. Simply take this one. So it will show us 10, 7, 6 is repeating. Okay, just grab this. I'll copy this one. Control C. Some product. Content. Total 23. Okay, 23. Again, is equal to count. Those are numbers, right, guys? Okay. Remove equal sign. We are not interested in equal sign. Just simply enter. Okay, enter. 3. Okay, now how to extract index? This one you have to extract. Okay. Any doubt, please let me know in the comment box, guys. E dollar. Okay. Enter. If you drag this formula, it will show like this. Reference error. Okay. Simply drag this. If it's not an array function, it's a normal function only. Control enter. Okay, too many arguments. Okay. Control enter. Double click. Okay, guys. 1076. Adding those numbers 23, total numbers 3, and those numbers are 1076. Okay. Here is the amazing thing. What I said. If you change any number over here, automatically that many numbers should come. I enter 3, so it has come 1, 2, 3 words. Okay. Here I will show you how to do it. Okay, guys. Substitute. Text. Comma. Old text. What will be the old text? Yes. A new text. I am doing any special character which is not in there in the sentence. Instant third instance means third space. 1, 2, third space. Okay, here it will come at the rate. Okay. Simply what we'll do? Left of this comma. Let's see what will happen. It won't come. Okay, so what we'll do, you have to find the search at the rate, sorry, not at the rate, ampersand, comma, in this code string. Okay. Now, number of characters, F9, is it 10, is it right, is it 10? Okay, let's see what will happen. Control enter. Is it 10? 3, 7, 8, 9, I think extra space here. Simply use trim, it will be extra space. Okay. Len of is equal to len of this. The extra space is good for that, we will be showing that one time. Okay. Okay, guys. 5 questions are over till now. I'll continue with the 6th assignment by tomorrow or whenever I get the time. And 11th assignment 11 to 20 is almost completed. 1 or 2 questions are there. I have to make it. Okay, guys. If you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment box. Thank you, guys. Thanks for your support. Have a nice day.